Okay, let's start.
This conference will now be recorded.
Right. So yesterday we have seen how to generate the selection screen for reading the user input. Okay, so we understood about the parameter statement, how to make the selection screen fields as mandatory fields, how to provide the default values. Okay. Now, in continuation to that, let's see another example. See, my requirement is same. This is my ABAP program. Okay. Okay, this is ABAP program. Now, when I execute this ABAP program, I should get a selection screen. Okay, I should get a selection screen. So, we already know how to generate the selection screen. Okay, on the selection screen, assume that we should have some input fields. Okay, these are the input fields like enter first number and enter what a second number, enter first number, enter second number, and I should have some radio buttons. Okay, I should have some 5 radio buttons. So I'll take some 5 radio buttons, something like this, with the options here. Okay, addition, something, a difference, product, okay, division, and what? None. Okay, so like this, I should have 5 radio buttons. Okay, so in this, I want to perform some validations. What are the validations? By default, the last radio button should be selected. Okay, by default, the last radio button should be selected, means whenever this radio button is whenever the selection screen is displayed, by default this 5th radio button should be what? Selected. By default, the moment the selection screen is displayed, the 5th radio button should be selected by default. Then the other validation is at any point of time user should able to select only what? 1 radio button. Okay, suppose the selection screen is displayed. Okay, now I'll select the what? Product. If I select the product radio button, the other radio button which was selected previously should be deselected. So at any point of time, user should be able to select only what? 1 radio button. Okay, then the next validation is on selecting the radio buttons, on selecting one of the radio button, and on click of what? Execute button. Okay, and on click of execute button, what you have to do? Identify the selected radio button, okay, identify the selected radio button and perform the appropriate operation. Okay, so this is my third validation. Perform the appropriate operation. Okay, and if you want, we can what take one more validation, which you already know. Yesterday we have seen both the input fields, should be what? Mandatory. Means compulsory. The user should enter what? Some value in this. Understood? So then on executing this, okay, on executing the selection screen, I should display the result in what? The list processing screen. Okay, I need to display the result in the list processing screen. So this is my list processing screen, the output screen. Okay, so here the main focus is how to design the radio buttons on the selection screen, and how do we restrict the user to select only one radio button, and how to identify the selected radio button. That is the main focus here. Okay, so let's see how to do it. So this is the overall requirement. Done. So I'll go to ABAP editor SC38. Right, so I'll give the program name as, the object name as something Z645. The stress program is program 2. Let me give the object name as program 3. Z645 program 3. I'll just give some title, selection screen, what, radio buttons, type of program is what, executable program. I'll save it in the local object. Done. So let us do it part by part. So the first requirement is what, on executing my program, I should get the selection screen to read how many input values. Two input values. So already we have seen yesterday, we need to use parameter statement to generate the selection screen. So I'll use parameters keyword. I'll use a chain operator because I want to declare what, multiple variables. Parameters, I'll give the variable name as something p_x type I. Okay, let me provide some default value also. So I'll say default something 20. Okay, and I'll declare another variable p_y type integer. I'll give the default value as something 15. Okay, something like this. Okay, so when I execute, I got the selection screen which contains what, some two input fields. So I have to give the meaningful text here, na, like enter first number and enter second number. So how do we do it? Yesterday we have seen, after activating a program, within the program itself we need to choose what, go to menu, text elements, what you have to select, selection text, understood? Go to text elements, selection text. So if I go for text element selection text, okay, we have two parameter variables. Let me provide the what, description. So I'll give the description as meaningful description, enter first number and enter what, second number. Done. So when I activate, done, I'll go back, activate this, execute. Done, I got the meaningful text. But my requirement is here, when I go for selection text, okay, I got the text from what, left hand side of the screen now. I got the text from the left hand side of the screen, but my requirement is this selection text should start from a particular position. It should start from a particular position, not from the extreme left side. By default, the selection text will start from what, extreme left side. I don't want that. So yesterday we have done the same thing. I got it in the left side. Here also I got it in the left side, but I don't want to start the text from here. I want to start from a particular position. Okay, so let's see how to do it. So since I want it on a particular position, let us see what are the changes you have to do. So I'll just remove the selection text. I'll go to text element selection text. I'll remove this text. I'll keep the question marks as it is. Done. Activate this. Right, so I removed the selection text. So when I execute, I got the variables back, p_x and p_y. So what is the agenda now? The text should be started from what, particular what line, okay, particular position. So here this is one line, try to understand, this is one line and this is another line. So if you take this first line, this first line should contain what, it should contain some label kind of thing, and it should contain what, some input field. Understood? So each line should contain one text label and one corresponding input field. So see, let us see what to do now. See, instead of doing like this, I'll just comment this. I'm commenting it. Right, see the change here. I'll use a statement called as selection screen begin of line. Selection screen begin of line, and then I'll say what? Selection screen end of line. Okay, begin of line and what? End of line. So let us focus on what? First line only. This only. Okay. So first, what I want here? I want a label text. I want some label kind of thing here. So for that, in the first line, I'll say we have a statement selection screen. Okay, to provide the labels, we have a what? A keyword called as comment. Selection screen comment. Understood? Comment. From which position you want to start the label? I want to start the label from some 8th position, for example. Understood? Starting from the left hand side, I want to start from the 8th position. So 8 of, in the parentheses, how much width you want to reserve for the label. Okay, let me reserve some 20 characters, 20 spaces. So how do we read this? Starting from the 8th character, reserve how many spaces? 20 spaces. Okay, so for this entire text, I need to give some variable name. I'll give the variable name as something LB1. You can give any name. I am giving what? LB1. Done. Okay, fine. Then in the same line, immediately after this label, what I want? Some input field. How do we generate the input field? By using what? Parameters. So I'll say parameters. Let me give a variable name as what? P_X. Type what? I. Let me provide some default value also. I'll give it as something 20. So understood, we are trying to design one line. That line should contain one label text and the corresponding input fields. This will generate what? Input field. This will generate the label. From which position? Starting from the 8th position, it will reserve how many spaces? 20 spaces. Okay, so let's see now. Save it. Check. No syntax error. Activate. When I execute, good. So I can see here, I got the input field here. Let me check where the cursor is blinking here. I can see the cursor is blinking from what? A particular position. Nothing but what? 8th position. Understood? Starting from the 8th position, it has reserved how many spaces? 20 spaces for that particular label. And after that, I got the input field. Am I clear? So we'll see how to provide the text for this. Okay, similarly, I want one more line. So let me construct one more line. I'll just copy this as it is. Begin of line, end of line. In the second line also, let me start from 8th position only. I'll give 8 of 20. I'll give the variable name as something LB2. LB2. Then I'll give the parameter name as P_Y type I. Let me give some default value. I'll give it as something 15. Let me check whether the second line is constructed or not. When I execute, yes, we have what? 2 lines. In the second line also, you can see cursor is blinking from what? 8th position, reserving some 20 spaces. Any questions in this part, please ask me. Okay, so fine. If there are no questions, now what is the next focus? Now I need to associate what? Text. I need to associate the text. So for that, what I have to do is we have to go for what? Event handling. Okay, we have to go for a concept called as what? Event handling. So first of all, let us understand what is the meaning of what? Event. Suppose event is nothing but what? Event is an action. Event is an action. Okay, so suppose on this screen I'll right click. Okay, when I right click, what I am getting? I am getting some context menu. I repeat, when I right click, I am getting a context menu. Means I am doing some action here. What is the action I am doing? I am right clicking. Someone is listening to my action. For my action, they have provided one reaction. What is that reaction? They are populating a context menu. We call it as what? Context menu. Understood? So event is nothing but what? An action. event is an action which is performed in the runtime. Okay, so here similarly, if I click on this start button, okay, on my system, if I click on start button, I am getting some context menu. No? So again, clicking the button is what? An event. I am doing some action. Someone is listening to that action and they are providing some reaction. Okay, so this is called as what? Event. So now why we are discussing about this is, in ABAP also or in any programming language, we have the concept of what? Event handling. Okay, by handling the events, we can provide dynamic features to your applications. I repeat, by handling the events, we can provide dynamism to your applications. Okay, by handling the events, we can provide dynamism to the applications. Means, suppose here, let's try to understand. So I wrote the ABAP program. Okay, when I wrote the ABAP program, in my ABAP program, when I execute this program, what happens here? In this case also, when I'm executing my program, when I execute, I'm getting a screen. This screen, we call it as what? Selection screen. So what you have to understand is, whenever we start the execution of the program, what happened? A selection screen is what? Displayed. Okay, so assume that this is your selection screen. The selection screen is displayed. Okay, but before displaying the selection screen, before showing the selection screen to the user, internally SAP will trigger, SAP will fire, SAP will raise. I can call it with different terminology. Okay, SAP will raise what? Some events. So what is that event means? The first event which will be raised is, there are many events. The first event raised is initialization event. Okay, so related to selection screen, we have many events. So one of the event is what? Initialization. Okay, initialization event. After firing, after raising initialization event, it will raise a event called as what? At selection screen output. It will raise a event called as what? At selection screen output. So without our knowledge, internally two events are getting what? Triggered. Okay, two events are getting triggered. What are the events? Initialization event and then what? At selection screen output. So what is the sequence flow you have to understand? Something like this. One second. So without, we should understand the concept, then we can easily implement any kind of what? Logic. So that's why it is important to understand this in sequence. So the moment I execute, by pressing what? F8, SAP will trigger which event? Initialization event. After triggering that, it will trigger what? At selection screen output. Okay, and then the selection screen is shown to the user. The selection screen is shown to the user. Okay, so what I have to do on the selection screen? Okay, here on the selection screen, I have to provide some input values and I have to click on what? Execute button. So we'll focus on what? Execute button later on. But from this diagram, it is evident that what is the first event triggered? Initialization event. So as we have to handle what? Initialization event. We have to handle the initialization event. Okay, and what you have to do? We need to provide the logic as part of initialization event to provide the text for your labels. Why only in the initialization event? We know that this is the first event triggered. This is the first event triggered whenever before displaying the selection screen. One second. Yeah. So this is the first event triggered before displaying the selection screen. So I need to handle that particular event. Whatever the default activity that you want to show to the user, the default activity, whatever you want to perform, that business logic we have to implement inside which event? Initialization event. So here also, the moment the selection screen is displayed to the user, the text should be shown to the user. Na? Am I clear? So the moment the screen is displayed, the text also should be shown to the user. So I need to do some default activity so that when the selection screen is displayed, everything will be defaulted. So what is the first event triggered here? initialization event. So I need to handle that event. Where do we handle the event? Events are always handled at the end of the program. Events are always handled at the end of the program. So here also what? Initialization event. Understood? Initialization event. Then what I have to do in the initialization event? What are my default activity that you want to do? That business logic you have to write inside this event. What is the activity? I have to initialize my variables. Na? What are the variable names I give? LB1 and what? LB2. So here I'll say LB1 is equal to, what is the text you want? Enter what? First number. Okay, then LB2 is equal to, enter what? Something second number. Save it, check, no syntax error, activate. So remember, events are always handled at the end of the program. So this event, when it will be triggered, this will be triggered before showing the screen to the user, before the selection screen is what? Displayed. So when I execute my program, SAP will check whether you have handled the initialization event. If the initialization event is handled, this will be executed. And then the selection screen will be shown to the user. So see now, when I execute, did I got that? I got the label starting from which position? 8th position. Enter first number and enter second number. Suppose wantedly here I'll say 8 of 10. 8 of 10. So when I execute, I am reserving how many spaces? Only 10 spaces. So that's why you can see only what? I got up to this only. Okay. I got only some 9 characters here, 10 characters including space. Is it clear? So that's why you should reserve what? Sufficient space. So I'll give what? 20. Am I clear? So what you have to understand is, whatever the initialization activity that you want to do, whatever the things you want to default to the user, those default things has to be implemented as part of which event? Initialization event. So that when the screen is shown to the user, everything will be what? Defaulted to the user. Okay, so is it clear so far? Forget about this at selection screen output. As and when required, we'll discuss. Why I'm not writing the logic inside this also, you'll understand later on. As of now, just remember, since initialization is the first event triggered, okay, I'm writing the default activity logic inside what? Initialization event. And this event should always be handled where? At the end of the program. Any event you have to handle at the end of the program. Any questions? Okay, done. So what is the next thing here? Events are like internal transactions. What do you mean by internal transaction, Justin? Internal means, yes, they will be executed without the user knowledge. Okay, some events will be executed without the user knowledge. Internally, they get what? Executed. But there are some external events also that we will understand going forward. External in the sense, suppose the selection screen is displayed to the user. Okay, now on the selection screen, I'll do some actions. Na, what are the actions I can do? I may press enter key in the input field, or I may select a radio button, or I may click a button. So depending on my action, depending on the user action, SAP will trigger what? Appropriate events. Here also, initialization event got triggered when I start execution. This is also an action only. Okay, when I start the execution, it will check whether the initialization event is handled. If it is handled, it will execute that particular logic inside that. Yeah. So now what is the next thing here? Okay, selection screen is available to us. In the selection screen, what else I want? I want some radio buttons. How many radio buttons? 5 radio buttons. Okay, so to design these radio buttons on the selection screen, so after this begin of line, end of line, see here. Events should always be handled where? At the end of the program, any event. So now what is my requirement? I need to construct some 5 radio button. So I'll say parameters. Okay, let me give the radio button names as P underscore R1. Any name you can give, but parameter variables will start with P. And for radio buttons, wantedly I'm giving R1, R2 kind of thing. I'll say radio button group. I'll give the group name. You can give any group name. I'm giving it as group 1. Like this, let me construct. I'm giving period here. All these radio buttons, I'm assigning it to only one group. What are the radio button names I am giving? R1, R2, R3, R4 and what? R5. All these radio buttons belongs to the same group. What is the group name? GRP1. Let me execute. Any group name you can give, I get a GRP1. When I execute, yes, I got what? 5 radio buttons. Understood? I got the 5 radio buttons. Am I clear? Done. Now, what is my requirement is, I don't want the radio buttons to be shown like that. What I want the meaningful what text, so that user will understand the purpose of that particular radio button. So how do you provide the selection text? Okay, same thing. Already we know that to provide the selection text, I'll choose go to text elements, selection text. So we have 5 radio buttons here. You provide the labels, whatever you want. Remove that question marks and provide the radio buttons. I'll give addition, what else, difference, then I'll give what, product, then I'll give what, division, then I'll give what, none. Done. Activate this, go back, activate and execute this. Yes, I got the meaningful radio button text. 5 radio buttons I got, and you can see the default behavior here. By default, which radio button is selected? First radio button is selected. Okay, in a group of radio buttons, by default the first radio button will be selected. But what is my requirement? What is my one of the validation? By default, the last radio button should be selected. So what I'll do here, just like yesterday we have seen, or today also, related to parameters we have seen some options, default, all those things. Okay, actually I forgot one validation. Both the input fields should be what? Mandatory. Okay, so how do you make the input fields mandatory? As we discussed, we have to use one keyword or addition called as what? Obligatory. Obligatory indicates what? Mandatory. Compulsory, the user has to enter the value. Done. So these are some of the additions related to what? Parameters. Now my requirement is fifth radio button should be selected by default. So for this fifth radio button, this is part of parameters only, na? For this fifth radio button, I'll say default. Try to understand default. A radio button can contain either of the following two values. A radio button can contain either X, or a radio button can contain either space as values. When it will contain X, whenever a radio button is selected, the value of the radio button will be set to what? X. Whenever the radio button is not selected, the value of the radio button will be set to what? Space. So it can contain only these two values, capital X, uppercase X, or what? Space. So here my requirement is what? Fifth one should be selected by default. Now, so I have to set it to what? X. Let me try to set as lowercase X. Let's see whether it will accept or not. I'm getting a syntax error. What is that? A parameter of a radio button group. A parameter of a radio button group can only have what? X as what? Default. A parameter of a radio button group can only have uppercase X as what? Default. So I cannot give whatever values I want. It will hold either uppercase X or space as what? Values. So now I am setting it to what? X. So see now, when I execute, yes, which one is selected by default? Fifth one is selected by default. So now, internally, what are the values of the radio buttons? First one is not selected. So P underscore R1 is what? Space. Second one is what? P underscore R2. It is also space. First four radio buttons will contain the value as what? Space, because they are not selected. Fifth one is internally having what? X. Now, all these radio buttons belongs to same group, na? Now in the runtime, this is nothing but runtime. Means the screen is shown to the user. I am doing some operations here. I am doing some actions here. Okay, so here I'll select the product radio button. What happened? The other one is automatically deselect. I'll select addition, automatically deselected. So why? Because all these radio button belongs to what? Same group. Suppose I'll do like this, GRP2, GRP2, GRP2. So what happened now? We have two different radio buttons. Okay, so in group 2, in group 2 we have 3 radio buttons. In group 1 I am having what? 2 radio buttons. So in group 2, which radio button will be selected by default? First one will be selected. In group 1 I am making the second one to be selected. So see now. Yeah, okay, understood. So depending on your requirement, you have to decide about the groups. Understood. So my requirement is what? I have to restrict the user to select only one radio button. So I am adding what? Only one group. Done. I got it. Hope it's clear related to radio buttons. Done. Now, okay, let me just come back to the initial screen. I'll just go back. If you see here, this is also a screen which contains some radio buttons, and it is showing it as a block kind of thing. I want the same thing. Means in my selection screen also, I want to show it in the form of blocks. These radio buttons should be shown in the block. So what I'll do, let me check whether I can do it for radio buttons or not. So here I'll say selection screen. We have a statement called as begin of block. Selection screen, begin of block. You have to give some name for the block. I'll give the name as what? BK1, some name. Then I'll say what? With frame. Then I need to provide some title. So title followed by variable name. I am giving the variable name as T1. Then I need to close the block. How do you close the block? Selection screen, end of block. What is the block name? BK1. Understood? So I am beginning the block, I am ending the block. What is the name of the block? BK1. And I get the title variable as what? T1. Some variable name T1. Let me check whether I am getting any block kind of appearance. Yes, I got a block kind of appearance. I want some title kind of thing. What is the title variable I gave? T1. So I need to default the value for this. Where do we do that? What is the first event triggered? Initialization. Understood? The title should be shown to me as and when the screen is displayed. So I have to give this value here. So in the initialization event, I'll say T1 is equal to some what title. I'll give it as something arithmetic operations. Some title I'm giving. Some meaningful title. Let me check it. Execute. Done. I got the title arithmetic operations. Hope it's clear up to this. Any questions? Done. So if there are no questions, yeah. What is the next focus now? Okay, I got this thing. This also, if you want to keep it in a block, you can keep. That is our wish. Okay, how to do it? Suppose let me give this as T2. You can give any name. Let me give this also what T2. Done. So for the input fields also, I want to put it in a block kind of thing. So what I'll do, I'll say selection what screen, what begin of what block. I'll give the block name as BK1 with the frame. I'll give some title. Let me give it as T1. Then here I'll say selection screen. What? End of block. What is the block name? BK1. This is another block name. Let me give it as BK2. I cannot have two things with the same name. So I'm giving a different name. What is the title variable I give for the first block? T1. Let me try to initialize here. I'll say T1 is equal to some title. I'll say enter what input values, some title, enter input values. So when I execute, yes, I got what? 2 blocks. Understood? So depending on our requirement, we need to use appropriate operations. Hope it's clear. Block concept. Done. What is the next requirement now? When I execute this program, then I am providing the input. Suppose I am not providing the value for the first one. I got a tick mark, na, which indicates what? It is mandate. It is obligatory. So when I execute, it will give me an error. Fill in all the required entry fields. Compulsory, I need to enter the sum value. Now my next requirement is I need to select a radio button. Depending on the selected radio button, when I click on the execute button, I should identify which radio button is selected and I have to do the appropriate operation. Right? So I have to click on what button here? Execute button. I have to click on what? Execute button. So we know that before displaying the selection screen to the user, how many events got triggered? Initialization event and what? At selection screen output. Now the selection screen is displayed to the user. On the selection screen, I'll do some action. What is that action I'll do? Try to understand. On my selection screen, my radio buttons are selected. Okay, I may select one of the radio button. Then I'll click on what? On click of what? Execute button. If I click on what? Execute button on the selection screen, SAP will trigger an event called as what? Start of selection. Understood? The selection screen is what? Shown to the user. I'm entering the input values. I'm selecting some radio button. Then I'll click on what? Execute button. Whenever I click on the execute button on the selection screen, what is the event triggered? Start of selection. So let me handle what event now? Start of selection. Okay, so already I've handled which event? Initialization event. So I can handle what? Start of selection. I can handle it here. Start of selection. Or I can handle it here. But make sure that all the events are always handled at the end. Okay. So in the start of selection event, okay, I can handle it here or I can handle it after what? Initialization. Doesn't matter. In any of the sequence I can handle. Irrespective of whatever the sequence I handle, SAP will trigger in its own sequence. Means it will always trigger what? Initialization first, then what? Start of selection. So let me show you that. Let me handle like this only. Start of selection. Done. So what I have to do now? I have to identify the selected radio button. Just now I told a radio button will have possible two values. Either of the two values. Either X or what? Space. If the radio button is selected, it will contain the value as what? X. If the radio button is not selected, it will contain the value as what? Space. It will contain the value as what? Space. Okay. So what I'll do here, okay, for storing the calculation, I require one variable. So how do you declare a normal variable? Already we know. Okay, so generally the variables will declare on the top, but I can declare it anywhere. Okay, but make an habit to declare it on the top. So I'll set data. Okay, I'll give the variable name as, generally we'll start with what? V underscore some name I'll give. V underscore Z type what? I. V underscore Z type what? Integer. So now let me check the condition in the start of selection event. Right? I have to check my program should identify which radio button is selected. So just like C language, ABAP also contains conditional statements like we have if else, case end case kind of thing. So I'll say if, what is the first radio button name? P underscore R1. If P underscore R1 equal to X, means if it is selected, do so and so. Else if the first one is not selected, you check whether the second one is selected. If P underscore R2 equal to X, do so and so. Else if, understood? In C language, C++, we'll open the floor brackets. But here, we have to use what? If and if kind of thing. Okay, else if, what is this? P underscore R3 is equal to what? X. Then I'll say, else if, P underscore R4 equal to what? X, do so and so. Okay, else means, if the first two four radio buttons are not selected, I can say what? Else if P underscore R5 equal to X. I can say like this. If four radio buttons are not selected, obviously the fifth one is selected. Na? Simply I can say else also. I need not check separately R5 is equal to what X. Directly I can say what? Else. Okay, else. End for if is what? End if. So understood. These are called as a conditional statements to check the conditions. Let me save it, check for the syntax, activate. Done? Okay. Okay, so now what I have to do? I need to write the business logic. If first one is selected, I need to do the addition. Where I am entering the input values in my variables p underscore x and what? P underscore y. I want to store this calculation in what? V underscore z. So I'll say here V underscore z is equal to p underscore x plus p underscore y. Then I'll say write how to display. I'm using the chain operator. I'll say sum is what? Sum is what? V underscore z. Else if p underscore r2 equal to x, similar kind of thing. P underscore x minus p underscore y. Here I'll say some meaningful message. Difference is so and so. Then this is product p underscore x into p underscore y. Here also product is done. And then here I'll say p underscore x by p underscore y. Here also what? Division is something, some meaningful message. Division is okay, right? What I'll say. Some meaningful message. What? None radio button selected. Okay, that's all. Okay, so this is the way you have to write the logic. So let me save it, check for the syntax error, activate this. Right, when I execute, I'm entering some input values. Some input values, I'll choose none only. I'll click on execute button. When I click on execute button, what is the event triggered? Start of selection. What is the logic I wrote? First I checked whether first one is selected. If r1 equal to x, no. What is the value of r1? Space. Else if r2 equal to x, no. All these conditions are failed. Last one is satisfied. When I execute, what I got? None radio button selected. I'll go back. I'll choose difference. What I got? 77 minus 15. Difference is what? 62. I'll go back. I'll choose product. I got what? 1150. It is showing it as dot. It is because of the system setting, but it is what? One comma. 1155. Okay. And then I'll choose division. Understood? So it is 5 point change. 5 point change. I got what? 5 only, because integers cannot store decimal values. So I got the integer part. What is that? 5 I got. Done. So everything is working fine. So how do we identify the selected radio button? If the radio button is selected, radio button will contain what value? X. Otherwise, it will contain what? Space. Any questions, please ask me. Now here we will have one issue here. Suppose I'll say 20 and 78, I'll choose difference. What is the expected result? 20 minus 78, minus 58 kind of thing. So when I execute, what I got? I got 58 minus, but I have to show the result as what? Minus 58. Internally it is minus 58 only, but this SAP is a German product. They'll represent in German, they'll represent the negative symbol in the right hand side. But according to our format, the negative symbol should be what? Before the value. Understood? So I'm having a issue in what? The product difference thing. Okay. So where we are having the issue here only, na? Here only. So I'm doing the difference here. That result is stored in what? V underscore Z. So what I'll do now? I need to do some adjustments. If you are trying to print the negative value, you have to remove that hyphen from the right hand side and keep the same hyphen in what? Left hand side in our own format. So what I'll do here after doing the calculation, I'll write nested if within the if. So I'll write one more condition here. If what? V underscore Z is greater than or equal to 0. If V underscore Z is greater than or equal to 0, means if it is a positive value, display it as it is, no problem. Else, so if this condition is not satisfied, if it is not greater than or equal to 0, obviously understanding is what? Less than 0 only, na? So else end for if is what? End if. What I have to do now? I have to remove the negative symbol from the right hand side and keep it what? Left hand side. So see the adjustment here. I'll say right. What difference is v underscore z already related to right statements. We have seen some options yesterday and in the last class, day before class, like color option, centered, right, justified, so and so. Similar to that, in the right statement, we have an option called as no sign. No sign. Understood? So when the control will come to else part, if the result is a negative value, control will come to what? Else part. So when I'm printing that, I am saying what? No sign means iPhone will not be shown to us. So when I execute, okay, 20 and 15. This is obviously a positive value. I got it fine. Difference is what? 5. Now I'll say this is 20 minus 150. I should get minus 130. I'll choose difference. What I got? Only 130. Because I said what? No sign there. Okay, so what I have to do? I have to represent that iPhone before the value. No? I have to represent that iPhone before the value. So what I'll do? Simple thing. Difference is, here I'll say what? iPhone. Just I have to show it as a negative value in the else part. When I'm printing that negative value in the string only, I'm enclosing that iPhone to indicate that as a negative value. Let me check whether it works or not. I'll choose difference. Yes, I got what? Negative value. But I got a space. I got a space. So what I already we know. Integers are right justified. I have to put it what? Left hand side. So what I'll do here in the else part only, I'll use another option here. What is this? Left justified. So that the iPhone and the value would be at the corresponding one by one. Left justified I'm using. Okay, I'll say 150. Something. Okay. I'll choose this. Yes, I got 130 minus, but still I'm getting a gap kind of thing. I'm getting a gap between the iPhone and the value. I'm getting the gap between the iPhone and the value. So between iPhone and this value, I'm getting a gap. So what I'll do, I will try to use an option called as before that comma, I'll use what? No gap. I'll try to use this no gap somewhere here. No gap. Okay. Will it recognize? Let me check. Save. Check. I'm getting an error. No gap is what? Unknown. So I cannot use these additions wherever I want. Okay, so it should not be before the variable, just before the comma. I'll say what? No gap. So now save it, check it, done. Yes, I got what? Minus 130. I'm giving a positive value. Yes, I got the positive, working fine. Understood? So what I'm trying to show here is, depending on our requirement, we need to format the output by using the appropriate options. Similarly here, if I select this fifth radio button, I got what? I gave a message what? None radio button selected. So if I use write statement, already we have seen yesterday, write statement will display the result on what? LPS. List processing screen, output screen we call it as well, list processing screen. So instead of doing that, instead of using write statement here, I'll just comment that I will use a statement called as message. Okay. So here I'll just give a message like what? None radio button selected. None radio button selected. Type. You want to show it as what type of message? We have different types of messages. Information message, warning message, status message, all those things. I'll say type what? I, capital I. In single quotes you have to say. Now see here, capital I in single quotes. So when I execute, right, I'll choose none only. I'll click on this. What I got? I got a information message. None radio button selected. Understood? Similarly, instead of using I here, I'll use yes means status, status message. So when I execute now, when I click on this execute button, yeah, you can see I got the message on the status bar. I got the message on the status bar. So depending on your requirement, how you want to show the message, we have to use appropriate message types. We have other message types also that we will discuss going forward as and when required. We have error message, we have warning message, we have abort message, okay, all those things. Okay, so I'll go for what? Information message. This I indicates what here in uppercase, in single quotes, information message. This is information message. This S indicates what? Status message. It will display on what? Status bar. None radio button selected. Okay, so this result also I want to show it in the message box only, so that requires some other discussion. I'll discuss that in the tomorrow session. Okay, any questions in this part, please ask me. I'll give you one exercise. If you have time, you try to do it. The exercise is check how we can do it. Otherwise, also I'll show it in the coming classes. Here, what I am doing, I'm entering the input values, I'm selecting one of the radio button, and I'm clicking on what? Execute button. I am getting the result. But my requirement is after entering the input values, the moment I select a radio button, the moment I select any of the radio button, okay, I should show the result. Here, what is happening? I'm selecting the radio button, then I'm clicking on what? Execute button. Okay, so when I click on the execute button, what is the event triggered? I said start of selection. Similarly, how you have to analyze now is we should check what is the event triggered the moment I select a radio button in the radio button group. I don't want to click on execute button. The moment I do the selection here, I should do the appropriate operation. Okay, so check whether you can do it or not. Otherwise also I'll cover those things tomorrow. Not tomorrow, in the coming class, might be tomorrow only, we'll see that. Okay, so what you have to focus is we should identify what is the event triggered when the radio button is selected. Here we are doing the selection and we are clicking on the execute button, but my customer may not ask for the execute button. He wants to show the result as and when the radio button is what selected. So check how to do it or which event you have to handle. Apart from that, any questions in this, please ask me. See, while listening now, it will be little look simple, okay, but you need to start practicing. Already I have shared the vendor details with everyone, so those who don't have the access, if you are interested, you can contact that vendor for taking that server access for rental basis. Okay, any questions? Challenge. So I'll wind off. We'll continue tomorrow with other what concepts. Chalo.